Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let us continue our discussion on the topic of surface area in polar coordinate. Suppose we have the curve, the r theta, such that the r is equal to the function of theta. It is in polar coordinate. And the theta between alpha and beta, where the alpha and beta are constant. So the curve is actually the blue curve between the theta is equal to alpha and theta is equal to beta. And then by using the definition of definite integral, then we can find the formula of the surface area of solid revolution. The solid revolution is from the curve C rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, and then we have the surface area is equal to S, the integral from alpha until beta, the square root of r square plus dr d theta square d theta, where the r is equal to the function of theta. We will see how to find the formula. Actually, the idea of the finding formula is just by using that we consider the function in polar coordinate as a parametric function, and then we use the formula of surface area in parametric function to find the surface area in polar coordinate. Here we are. So once again, to find the surface area of solid revolution in polar coordinate, from the formula of surface area of the parametric equation. That means we consider the polar equation as a parametric equation. Here we have the following. Suppose r is equal to f theta, where the theta between alpha and beta. Because the x is equal to r cos theta, this is actually the connection between the polar coordinate and Cartesian coordinate. So x is equal to r cos, but the r here is equal to f theta, so the x is equal to f time cos. This is actually the parametric equation. And the y theta is equal to r sin, this is from the calculus 1, is equal to f theta sin theta. This is also parametric equation of the y. So that the dx dt is equal to the prime, the f prime of theta cos theta minus the f theta sin theta, because the derivative of cos is minus sin. And the dy d theta is equal to the f prime theta sin theta plus f theta cos theta, because the derivative of sin is cos, not minus. But anyway, because we want to make it quadratic, so the result are the same. The dx dt square, the dy dt square, the minus become plus. So altogether, if we count by using the quadratic formula, the dx dt square, this two part to be square, this also part to be square, and because the cos square theta and sin square theta is equal to 1, then we have the f theta square plus f prime theta square, and it is equal to r square. This is actual r square, and f prime theta is equal to dr theta, because the r is equal to f theta. So we have this square is equal to r square plus dr theta square. And then by using the surface area for the parametric function this s, yeah, then we have that the s is equal to phi integral alpha beta y theta the square root of the x d theta square plus dy d theta square. But this is equal to what? This expression is equal to this one. This equal to this. So we can substitute this to this. So we have, actually it is replaced by this. But the y is equal to r sin. This is the connection between the polar coordinate and Cartesian coordinate. So the s is equal to 2 phi integral alpha beta r sin theta the square root of r square plus dr d theta square d theta. Or we can also can express this formula by using the last line. R is equal to f theta, so this f theta. So 2 phi the integral from alpha to beta f theta sin theta the square root of this is r is equal to f theta square plus f prime f theta square d theta. So we have this formula for the surface area of solid revolution in polar coordinate. Once again, we derive this formula just by considering that the polar coordinate can be viewed as a parametric function. Here we have two example. First example, if the r is equal to f theta is equal to a, that is actually a circle equation, but in polar coordinate, from the theta is equal to 0 and until theta is equal to pi divided by 4. This is the curve, the blue one. If the blue one is rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have the right side pictures. This shape. This shape is solid revolution, and it has area of the surface. The area of the surface is in polar coordinate r is equal to f theta is equal to r. So altogether we have that the s is equal to phi integral alpha beta, where the alpha is equal to 0 and the beta is equal to phi divided by 4. F theta sin theta the square root of f theta square plus f prime theta square d theta. Because the f theta is equal to a, so it is a sin theta. F theta is equal to a, this is a square. F prime theta is equal to 0 because f theta is constant. So this integral become this that integral to phi integral 0 until phi divided by 4 of this expression of this function. This is very easy to count by using the definite integral, and the result is equal to the phi a square times a minus square of a. This is positive because the 2 is bigger than a square of 2. So in conclusion, the surface area of this shape, the surface area of this picture is equal to phi a square times 2 minus square of 2. This is the first example. The second example, if we have a circle like this, this circle has a radius a, has radius a, but the center is not in 0.0, but in 0, a. The expression in polar coordinate is the r is equal to f theta equal to 2a sin theta from 0 until phi, so that the r itself is equal to r sin theta, so the y is equal to 2a sin theta O equal to 2a sin square theta. And of course, the dr dt here, dr dt theta here is equal to 2a times the derivative of sin, that is cos theta. And so, SOX, that is the surface area of this circle, when the circle is rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, then the SOX, the surface area, is equal to 2 phi integral 0 until phi, because the angle here from 0 until phi, this is phi divided by 2, this is phi. So the integral 2 phi integral 0 until phi, the y square root of r square plus dr d theta square d theta. So it is equal to 2 phi integral 0 until phi. Y is equal to 2a sin square, 2a sin square theta, the square root of r square. The r is here, so the square is 4a square sin square theta, plus the dr theta is equal to this one. So this is 4a square cos square theta. Okay? Because if we take it out from the parenthesis, then we have that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So altogether become 4a square plus y square. So 8 plus a square. So altogether we have it is equal to 2 phi integral 0 until phi 4 a square sin square theta. It is very easy because the sin square theta is equal to 1 cos 2 theta divided by 2. So by simple calculation, we have 4 times phi square times a square unit area. Okay, so in conclusion, if the circle like this, the equation of the circle is R is equal to 2a sin a, that is actually the circle with radius a and the center 0 comma a, and we rotate it one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have the surface area, and the surface area of that is equal to SOX is 4 phi square a square. So that is the example, the two example of the surface area in polar coordinate. We can also refer from many book. One of the book is Sullivan and Miranda, like this. This is example many exercise, extension and so on. Surface area like this, like that, and so on. So that's all that I want to say about the surface area. The surface area of the solid revolution in polar coordinate. Because we still have several times, maybe 5 minutes more, I would like to give you once again example. In explicit function, for instance, we want to count the area of the sphere, the surface area of the sphere. If we want to count the surface area of the sphere, we can easily do by using the function f theta, fx is equal to the square root of the r square minus x square. That is actually the equation of the circle in the first and the second quadrant. So y is equal to the square root of a square minus l. Y is equal to fx is equal to square root of r square minus x square. Actually, it is circle equation in the first and second quadrant. So above the x-axis, if the if we rotate it one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have the sphere with radius r, which is you see the formula is equal to 4 pi a square. But how to find this formula? By using the following. The y is equal to this one, so the dy dx is equal to minus x divided by the square root of a square minus x square, so that the 1 plus dy dt square is equal to 1 plus x square divided by a square minus x square equal to a square divided by a square minus x square. So by using the formula of surface area for explicit function, then the SOX is equal to 2 pi the integral minus a until a, because this is from the first and second quadrant of y ds. So this is equal to this, the ds is this, so this is actually equal to the integral of minus from minus a until a of the y is here, ds is here, ds is here. So the 2 phi integral minus a until a, the square root of the y is equal to square root of a square minus x square, and the ds is this, the ds is the square of this dx. The square of this is a divided by the square of a square minus x square dx. So it can be cancelled, these two. So this is equal to 2 phi integral minus a until a dx. So equal to 2 phi a of x divided minus a until a. So altogether we have the 4 phi a square. So in conclusion, we have that if you have the sphere with radius r, if you have a sphere with radius a, then the surface area of the sphere is 4 phi a square unit area. That is addition example in Bahasa Indonesia for the surface area for explicit function. One more example for parametric equation. This is very famous. You see asteroid. The parametric equation of asteroid is actually x equal to a cos power 3 theta, and the y is a sin power 3 theta from 0 until 2 phi. So like this one. And if we rotate this cardioid, if we rotate this asteroid one round surrounding the x-axis, then we have the volume. Okay. And also we have the surface. In the last video, I described you about the volume, but right now we describe about the area. The area of the solid revolution coming from the curve rotated one round surrounding the x-axis. By using the formula for the surface area in parametric equation, we have to find the dx dt is equal to this one, the dy dt is equal to this one, so that the dx d theta square is equal to the 9 a square cos power 4 theta sin square theta, and the dy d theta square is equal to 9 a square sin theta square cos sin power 4 theta cos of square theta cos square theta. And it implies that this equal to 9 a square sin square theta cos square theta. So the SOX, this is the surface area, according to the formula of the surface area in parametric equation is equal to 2 phi integral from 0 to phi divided by 2 y square root of the dx theta square plus dy theta square d theta. This is equal to 2 phi integral from 0 until phi divided by 2. Why it is only from 0 until phi? Because it is enough to count in the first quadrant. After the first quadrant is obtained, then you can multiply by 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 quadrant. So that's enough. So it is equal to 2 phi integral 0 until phi plus 2 of this expression. That's why using the technique of integration and the definite integral, we can easily calculate that this is equal to 6 divided by 5 phi a square unit area. So this is the SOX. So actually in the first quadrant pertama, if the asteroid in the first quadrant here, the blue one here, is rotated one round surrounding the x-axis, then the surface area is equal to 6 divided by 5 phi a square. But if we look at on the picture, if we count only in the first quadrant, that means we only count one half. So if the asteroid in the first and the second quadrant is rotated one round to surrounding the x-axis, then the volume become 2 times, because the first quadrant and the second quadrant the surface are the same. So this is 2 times. So 2 times, that means 3 divided by 5 phi a square. So that's all that I want to say. This is the diktat. There is some exercise here. For instance, for the cycloid, you can also make it as assignment for the student to calculate the surface area, which is from the cycloid rotated when the cycloid is rotated one round surrounding the x-axis. Here also the ellipse. So we have ellipsoid. You have to find the area of the ellipsoid, and so on and so on. So that's all that I want to say. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Let us join with our channel. If you like it, then share, like, and subscribe. Please share to other people that maybe it is become more important, powerful of mathematics and so on. Later on, we want to make this channel as a public channel. I want to say that in this channel, concentrate not only for lecture like this, because this lecture is actually for the university level. Later on, I would like to think about mathematics is a language of science. If mathematics is a language of science, then we can make some video, the importance of mathematics, the help of mathematics in many, many sciences. But not only science in university, but also science in maybe in junior high school, in senior high school, and so on. We will say later on after finishing our lecture. So thank you very much. I am sorry because this video is very simple and not professional because I am still a little bit sick. So I don't have any time to edit it and so on. But this is intended to be a lecture in Gajah Mada University during the COVID-19 pandemic. But afterward, I think we would like to make this channel more professional. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.